all time. After 3 years of meticulous design and arduous construction, History Supreme was finally created. Calling History Supreme a superyacht doesn't quite do her justice. For one, the yacht doesn't cost hundreds of millions. It was bought for $4.8 billion. And this yacht doesn't look like any other boat you've ever seen. The History Supreme's exterior is plated with platinum and gold. In fact, the 100-foot vessel holds over 200,000 pounds of precious metals within its composition. Along with the gold and platinum adorned exterior, the deck, the dining area, the rails, and even the anchor are garnished with the priceless metals as well. Seems like a bit much, huh? Well, then let's take a trip down to the master suite, and you'll find that it features a wall piece composed of meteorite and authentic Tyrannosaurus Rex bones. That's right. And if the space rock and dinosaur bone aren't enough to marvel at, Hughes also included a 24-karat gold Aquavista Panoramic Wall Aquarium. So, you understand why we don't think superyacht is an accurate classification. For now, we'll put History Supreme in the category of floating aquarium housing prehistoric space museums touched by Midas himself. Hughes also left an 18.5-karat diamond liquor bottle and an iPhone wrapped in 500-cut diamonds, just as a couple cherries on top. So, who's the one who purchased this $4.5 billion yacht and all that comes with it? Well, History Supreme was purchased by an anonymous Malaysian businessman. However, there's only one businessman in Malaysia worth more than $5 billion, and that's Robert Knok. So, it's assumed that he's the owner of this incredible boat. According to Forbes, in 2018, Robert Knok was listed as having a net worth of $14.8 billion, which would make him the richest man in Malaysia, as well as providing him enough cheddar to purchase the priciest yacht he could find. While History Supreme is without a doubt the most expensive yacht in existence, it isn't even close to the biggest. At just 100 feet, and despite the presence of T-Rex bones, History Supreme is actually quite average when it comes to size. The largest yacht is named Azam. Azam is owned by the President of the United Arab Emirates, a country that epitomizes luxury. At an incredible 590 feet, Azam is said to be the most complex and challenging yacht that has ever been built. Designed by Christophe Leone, this massive boat has everything you didn't know a boat needed. On Azam, you can feel at peace because you're making good use of the spa, or you can feel at peace because of the yacht's missile defense system. You can take off from the helipad, or you can just board the submarine. Swim in the pool, work out at the gym, the possibilities seem endless when you're aboard this $650 million yacht. While Azam is the biggest yacht in the world, it is still somehow able to reach speeds over 30 knots. To say that this is a technological feat is an understatement. Azam's owner, Sheikh Khalifa, as we mentioned, is the President of the United Arab Emirates. As it turned out, Khalifa's best friend, the Prime Minister of the UAE and ruler of Dubai, owns a very similar yacht named Dubai. I wonder if the two of them have ever had a yacht race. Dubai is about 60 feet shorter than the Azam, but shares a lot of the same features. The Prime Minister also owns an island called Logo Island, and in order to accommodate his superyacht, he had to make significant adjustments to the land of the island. Isn't it always such a hassle when you have to change things about your island to make room for your yacht? Ugh. The second most expensive yacht, as well as the second largest yacht, is named Eclipse, and is owned by the Russian billionaire Roman Abramovich. Abramovich is best known outside of Russia for his ownership of Chelsea Football Club in the English Premier League. This 536-foot yacht was built by Blom and Voss of Hamburg, Germany, and is valued at $1.5 billion. That's a whole lot of money, but notably, not even a third of the price of the History Supreme. The boat is so massive, it takes a crew of 70 people to maintain it. Perhaps the most impressive feature of the Eclipse is its security. The boat is fitted with complex intruder detection systems, as well as missile defense systems. The windows of the master bedroom and bridge are bulletproofed as well. Or maybe the most impressive feature of the yacht is the disco hall. It all depends on the person. Abramovich could easily have the whole Chelsea squad on the boat for a weekend or two, with the boat's 24 guest cabins and 2 swimming pools. And at 536 feet long, I'm sure players could find plenty of room to kick a ball around. Eclipse also has 2 helipads, just in case you need to use two of your helicopters, three launch boats used to take ashore or just to explore around the yacht, and a mini submarine that can dive down to 50 meters. You'd be hard-pressed to run out of things to do if you ever got to spend time on the Eclipse. The fifth yacht to make this list has not actually been built yet, but even though it's still in the making, we appreciate the builder's ambition so much, we had to include it. The vision of this yacht concept is self-explained in its name, Streets of Monaco. The yacht will serve as a scaled-down replica of Monaco on water. Yacht Island Design of Derbyshire County in England, the designers of Streets of Monaco, expect the boat to cost upwards of $1.1 billion. A pretty steep price, but then again, you would be buying a miniature city. The 500-foot yacht will feature some of the most famous landmarks of Monaco, including the racetrack of the Circuit de Monaco and the Monte Carlo Casino. The boat will be able to accommodate 16 guests and will have swimming pools and tennis courts. The plans also include a cafe with underwater views, barbecue facilities, submarines, and of course, what's a super yacht without a couple of helipads? This yacht, just like the Eclipse, should take a crew of about 70 to maintain. There's a saying that goes, "The happiest day of a man's life is the day he buys a boat. The second happiest day of a man's life is the day he sails that boat." Like no other possession, a boat continues to take your money long after you've paid for it. These boats all cost over hundreds of millions by themselves, but the kicker you get with owning a yacht is the money it takes to maintain it. Anything kept in salt water needs to be cleaned constantly. So, there's cleaning staff, and cleaning supplies is regular expense. Every super yacht needs a captain and a crew, and captain salaries can be upwards of $200,000 a year. Any self-respecting yacht has a chef and a staff to go along with them, so you must factor in those salaries as well. Docking fees are a constant expense anytime you park the boat to stay on land. Then you've got insurance cost, and the cost of repairs if anything goes wrong. And most importantly, fuel. Hundreds of thousands of dollars in fuel. So, you can see the cost of maintaining these colossal boats is just outrageous. In theory, a $10 million yacht will cost you $1 million a year to maintain. You can imagine then how these yachts that all cost over $1 billion take to maintain each year. By rule of thumb, a $1 billion yacht would cost $100 million a year to maintain. It's hard to know the exact amount with these $1 billion yachts because there are only a handful of them in existence. Either way, we know that it's an extraordinary amount of cash. Another incredible boat sailing the seas these days is the Royal Caribbean's Symphony of the Seas. This massive vessel isn't a yacht, but we think you'll understand why we felt like we had to include it. The Royal Caribbean's Symphony of the Seas is a cruise ship that earned an appearance on this video because it's widely considered the most luxurious cruise ship in existence. It's the biggest cruise ship ever created, at 1,188 feet. As well as the most expensive, at $1.35 billion. The cruise offers families an incredible luxurious vacation experience. One suite in particular garnered a lot of attention for earning the title of the most expensive room on any cruise ship. Families who rent out the most expensive room on the world's most expensive cruise ship will be treated to the most lavish vacation you could imagine. The ultimate family suite is spread across two levels of the ship and takes up a whopping 1,346 square feet. Although the guests won't be lacking any activities outside their room, guests in the suite won't ever have to leave their quarters. The suite has everything kids and parents could ask for. Just a few of its features include a ping pong table, an air hockey table, and a slide to get from the top floor to the bottom. The balcony is even equipped with a full-size whirlpool hot tub with unobstructed views of the beautiful ocean. Kids will be floored when they walk into their room and see the suite's Lego wall, and thrilled to find a 3D cinema room and popcorn machine in the other room. The family suite can sleep up to 8 people, all of whom have access to a personal butler. How's that for luxury? However, if you planned on taking your family on this magical vacation, you'll need to be willing to empty out your wallet a few times over. A family of 4 can book the 7-day vacation suite at a starting price of $50,000. The Royal Caribbean makes 2 different voyages, depending on which season you choose to take your vacation. During the summer, the 7-day cruise treks its course across Europe through the Mediterranean, making stops in Spain, France, and Italy. When winter comes in November, the Symphony of the Seas heads across the Atlantic, down to Miami. From there, it will depart on trips through the Caribbean. There you have it, 5 very expensive boats. Do you think they're worth it?